Very warm welcome to one and all. I hope you're doing great. So let's start with the next topic, which is regular expression. What do you mean by regular expression? Any idea? If I want to simply put it as an example, let's take Google search. Whenever we search something on the internet, the text, search text, is broken down into words, and then those words are further broken down into alphabets. So what exactly happens is each alphabet is combined to form a meaningful word, and then that word is compared with a repository of words, which is in short called as a database. So whenever some string matching or string pattern kind of an activity happens, it is done with the help of a literal, or it is done with the help of a value, of a concept called as regular expression. So let's see what exactly is a regular expression. We can define a regular expression or a regex or regexp as a sequence of characters that define a search pattern. Usually such search patterns are used by string searching algorithms to find and replace operations on strings or for input validation. In simple terms, as I had just now explained, if you want to search something on the internet, at the backend, what exactly happens is the particular search pattern is being broken down into words, and then regular expressions are being formed, which are then used by the computer to detect whether the particular search pattern is matching or not. Okay, so in basic form, we can explain regular expression as an analogy to computer programs. For example, high level languages cannot be understood by the computers. So what exactly happens is those high level languages are then broken down into machine readable languages, bytecode in case of Java. So whenever those machine languages are formed, that can be easily understood by the computer. Similar concept, similar thing happens over here. The high level languages, for example, the search pattern is broken down into corresponding regular expressions, which are then understood by the computer. So at the end of the day, we are designing a machine which will behave as a computer. So we would be implementing certain theory, certain logic, which can be understood by the computer, and hence regular expressions came into picture. Just take a few example. If I want to design a regular expression to accept languages which can either accept A or B, that is, either A will be accepted or B will be accepted. Such a machine can be written by a simple regular expression, something like this: A plus B, where plus denotes OR. Okay, we can have a alternate representation of this. We can also write A slash B or vertical slash. We can say A or B. We use this in programming language. Or same thing happens over here, A or B. That also means A or B. Similarly, the next is A and B. What do you mean by A and B? Whenever I'm saying A and B, it simply means you must have both of them present in the string. Hence, such a particular pattern can be broken down into a regular expression, something like this, A dot B, where dot denotes AND. Clear? It simply means it is a combination of A and B. We can also write it like this, AB. This also means the same. Clear? The next part is all possibilities of A. Whenever we're saying all possibilities of A, we define it something like this, A raised to star, or A closure. We say that this is a closure of A. Whenever such a closure comes, it is also called as epsilon closure, which means we will be having all possible combinations of A, even including the null values. So it is nothing but, the example can be something like this, A, A raised to 0, A raised to 1, A raised to 2, A raised to 3, and so on. So basically it will be something like this, epsilon followed by A, 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 triple A, and so on. This is what we call as all possibilities of A. Lastly, there is one concept called as all possibilities of A except null. So whatever we got in the above case minus the null value will give me this value, that is all possibilities of A except null. It is also represented something like this. Okay, so it is nothing but it will only have the positive values of A, or we can say except the null value. Clear? This is how we can generate regular expressions in the very basic form. Now let's take further examples. We are having few examples here which will clear your doubts about how and why regular expressions are being used. Let's see. The very first question in consideration is set of all the strings that start with A over the inputs A comma B. Clear? So we need to create a regular expression in which the inputs are starting with A, and it should it is not mentioned about the part with which it should be ending. So we had the liberty that the string is starting with A. Okay, that we know. What else is given? It is starting with A over the input characters A comma B. So now we know that only A I can't be using. I have to use B also, because it is present over the alphabets A comma B. So I know that if I write only A, the string would be incomplete. So what I need to do is I need to add a combination of either A or B raised to star. What does the star mean? The star means any possible combinations of A or B. Whenever I'm saying any possible combinations, it can be either zero also. So let me generate the expression, or let me generate the language that is being depicted by this regular expression. Okay, so if I put a zero over here, zero as in if I put a null character over here instead of this A or B, that simply means that there is no character present inside the bracket. That is also possible. How? Because just now I told you that if we have any possible combinations of A, it can also have something like this, right? Epsilon, which means a null character or a null string. So in such a case, in worst case scenario, the string may only consist of a single character A. But that is also satisfying my condition, right? Why and how? Basically, my question is set of all the strings that start and end with A. If I'm having a single character A, it is anyhow going to start with A and end with A, right? So my logic is correct. So this is the regular expression which we exactly want. Clear? So the language will be something like this: A A A B A A. Now possible three combinations: A A A A B B. It can't be A A B. Why? Because it can either be A or B B, right? Because there is an OR operation in between. So it can either consist all the combinations of A or all the combinations of B. It can never be AAB or ABA. Clear? So the string will be something like this at the end. I'm just rubbing out all the values which are not possible in this case. Okay, so it can be triple A, four times A, and so on. But it can never be ABAB. A mixed value can never be present, because we are having either combinations of A or combinations of B. So that's it for this particular example. Let's see the next example. Set of all the strings that either end with 0 or 1 1. The question is a little tricky for the first timers. The question says that we have to create a set of all the strings that ends either in 0 or in 1 1 over the inputs 0 comma 1. So how to design it? First of all, read the question properly. That end either, whenever I'm saying either, which means either A or B, either X or Y or whatever. So whenever I'm saying either, means it simply translates to or. Correct? So whenever I'm saying or, a plus sign has to be there somewhere in between. Okay, so we have to break the question into two parts. One part will be focusing on this 0, and the other part will be focusing on this 1 1. So what we need to do is we need to create set of all the strings that end either in 0. This is the first part. If the string is ending either in 0, which means it should be something like this. In between there is an OR operation, and the next part is set of all strings that end in 1-1. So it's similar to this. There has to be something in between the brackets. We will fill it up later. It will look something like this. That is, the string will either end with 0 or end with 1. Is it complete? No. We have to put a star over here for the first thing to be complete. That is, there can be any possible combinations of either 0 or 1. I have made a slight mistake over here. It is over the input 0, 1. Okay. So similarly, we will be having 0 plus 1 closure over here, because we can have any possible combinations of 0 or 1 at the beginning. But according to the question, it has to be strictly ending with 0 or ending with 1-1. So this is my regular expression. Clear? Next regular expression. Set of all the strings that start with A and end with B. It is very simple. If I refer the first question over here, it is quite similar to that. But over here we were having only one condition, but in this case we are having two conditions at the same time. Set of all strings that start with A and end with B. So there can't be any plus in between, because we are having a keyword AND over here. So what will happen? Start with A and end with B. So it has to be a part of a single statement, single condition. Okay, so what we can do is, we can fill it up with the combinations of A or B. Clear? This is my answer. Next, set of all the strings that start with X and end with XY. This might seem simple, but have a look once again. Set of all the strings that start with X and. So first thing first, there is no presence of any plus operation. Or is there? Just think of it twice. Okay, let me first finish this and then you can apply your logic. Set of all the strings that start with X. So I know that the string will be starting with X. Then there will be any combinations of X plus Y. Okay. And it should end with XY. It seems very simple, very straightforward. But is it complete? Tell me. Is it complete? I don't think so. Why? Because, take an example. If I put epsilon over here, what will be the language which is generated? Language will be X, because I'm having X over here. This will be 0. Second middle part will be 0. And this will be XY. So the least string which I will get from this particular regular expression is XXY, which is satisfying my condition, no doubt. What is my question? It should be starting with X and ending with XY. This is proper, starting with X and ending with XY. But what about this particular statement, XY? It is also starting with X and it is also ending with XY, isn't it? Because if I'm having only XY, then it is starting as well as ending with XY, right? So this string, this particular XY string is missing in this language. So what we need to do is, we simply need to add one pattern, which is also called as a merge pattern, that is an extra pattern to the statement which I have generated just now over here. So this is called as a merge pattern or an extra pattern, because the language which was generated by the previous regular expression is not sufficient enough to have this pattern also included in it. So that's why we have included another pattern which is called as a merge pattern. Clear? So this is the typicality of this particular problem. Let's see the fifth one, which is set of all the strings that start with ABB and end with BBA. It is similar to the fourth one. So it is starting with ABB. In between there will be any possible combinations of A and B, and it is ending with BBA. So apply the similar logic as we had applied in the fourth problem. If I replace it by epsilon, what will be the language that is generated? ABB and BBA, isn't it? But what about the merge patterns? Here also we need some kind of merge patterns. What are those merge patterns? Have a look. ABBA, this is also starting with ABB and this is also ending with BBA, but this particular language is not generated by this regular expression. So what we need to do, we would simply need to add some patterns called as the merge patterns to the problem, to the regular expression generated just now. Clear? What else? Can we move ahead any further? I guess we can. See, this is also a string which is starting with ABB and ending with BBA. This is also not being accepted by this machine, by this language. Yes or no? So hence, we would also need to add that into our regular expression to make it a general model to accept all the patterns which are starting with ABB and ending with BBA. So these are called as merge patterns. Clear? Same goes with this. Okay. The last problem of regular expressions is set of all the strings that start and end with different characters. Now we are having start and end with different characters over the alphabets X, Y. So it is very simple. Over the characters X, Y. So we need to have X, X plus Y, closure and Y. Simple, but it's not enough. Because here it is starting with X, ending with Y. But what about this? This is also starting with a different character, right? And ending with different character. So just a single statement won't be sufficient. We would be requiring another statement like this. So this is the complete regular expression. 1 plus 2. That is X, X plus Y closure Y plus Y, X plus Y closure X. That is strings starting and ending with different characters. So that was all about the introduction to regular expressions. I guess you got a clear understanding of what exactly regular expressions are. In the next lectures, we would be solving few problems based on the conversion of regular expressions to finite automata and the vice versa. Thanks for attending my lecture. Stay tuned for the upcoming videos. Thanks.